How to call the name of alkene? Aliphatic hydrocarbon. Listen. Aliphatic. But we call alkene unsaturated hydrocarbon. Unsaturated hydrocarbon means the hydrocarbon compound with double bond or triple bond in the structure. So we start with alkene. Alkene. When you want to call the name of alkene, the first thing you must do is you must choose the longest chain of carbon atom with double bond. If it has only same chain, okay, you count carbon atom and use Greek language. Do you remember about Greek language? If you see carbon 1, you use met. If you see carbon 2, you use eth. If you see carbon 3, pro. If you see carbon 4, bu. Please spell bu. Bu. Okay, but. If you see carbon 5, pen. Please spell pen. Go T-E-N-T. Okay. If you see carbon 6, you use 6. X. Please spell H. S. E. F. Okay. If you see carbon 7 atoms. H. Please spell H. S. E. T. T. And if you see carbon 8. O. O. Please spell O. If you see carbon 9 atoms, nona, please spell nona. N-O-A. And if you see carbon 10 atoms, dead, please spell dead. Yeah, very good. You can count carbon atom and you can use Greek language. Make it O, bu, pen. Take it off dead. No and deck. So if the hydrocarbon is alkane, you add N at the end. But today, hydrocarbon is alkene. We will add in at the end. But the name of the alkene, the name of the alkene is different from alkane. Different because we must call the name of alkene with the position of double bond. You must tell which carbon atom start double bond. You must tell the number 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Oh, okay. Look at the first structure. The first structure. The first structure, how many carbon atoms in the structure? 6. And what's the number of carbon atoms start double bond? 1. So when you want to call the name, you put 1 hyphen and break C. Okay, understand? 1 hyphen, break C. And number 2, if you want to see another structure, if you want to see another structure, we call it isomer. Do you remember the meaning of isomer? Can you tell me? Who can tell me? The meaning of isomer. What is the meaning of isomer? Isomer. Same. Same molecular formula, different structural formula. The structure number 1, C6H, how many H atom? 12. All of this structure, the same molecular formula, but you will see the different structural formula when you move double bond. Technique. You must see. Move double bond. make different structure and make different name of the compound together. Different structure and different the name of the compound. So number two, we call number two. What is the name of the structure number two? 2-hexene. Why do you call 2-hexene? Why do you call 2-hexene? Because what? Number five. Who's the number five? Who's number five in this room? Number five. Tisana. Okay, Pepe. Okay, your nickname Pepe. Why Pepe call this structure 2-hexene? Why do you call 2-hexene? Why? Pepe. Okay, if you cannot speak in English, you can answer me in Thai. In Thai. Why? Why, Pepe? Okay, Pepe. Can you tell me? Why do you call 2-hexene? Double bond อยู่ตำแหน่งที่สอง Okay. Clap your hand to your friend. EIS means English for Integrated Study. So if sometimes you cannot speak in English, you can tell me in Thai. Don't worry about English if you cannot tell. Speak Thai only and after that, think in English. Okay? Think in English. So in English, why do you call the number 2-hexene? Because carbon number 2 start double bond. Carbon number 2 start double bond. So we put number 2 before the name of the parent chain. Do you understand parent chain in Thai? What is the meaning in Thai for parent chain? Parent chain in Thai. So man. So man. Or another name. So like parent chain in English in Thai. Not mother chain. Parent chain or. So man. So like no. Okay, number three. The structure number three we call 3-hexene. Carbon number 3 start double bond. Okay. You can move. Can you move double bond between carbon number 4 and number 5? Can you move? No. Why? If you put the double bond between carbon number 4 and 5 in the structure is number 3. Can you move? No. Because why? It will have the same name as number two. Okay, I think you can understand. Number four, the name of the alkene. If you move double bond, move, and at the end you can move. You can move double bond already. You change another way. Another way, what way? Cut one carbon atom in the structure that you can move double bond. Cut one carbon atom and make it blank chain. When you want to make blank chain, you must start with what number of carbon atom? You must start when you want to make blank chain. What number of carbon atom? 2. Can you make blank chain at carbon number 1? Can you make blank chain at carbon number 1? No. Because if you make blank chain at carbon number 1, it will have the structure like L form. L form and U form is the same as the strand chain. Understand? So you cannot make blank chain at carbon number 1 or carbon at the end. The first carbon atom of the strand chain or the last carbon atom of the strand chain. You cannot make blank chain. It will have L form or it will have U form. U and L the same as strand chain. Okay, so the structure number 4. The number 4 we call blank, call the position of alkyl group. What's the number of carbon atom? 2. And how many carbon atom in branch chain? 1. If you see carbon 1, you use make. And branch chain is alkyl group. You think about make. But the name of alkyl, you must F-Y-L in Thai. Yl. Make F-Y-L. You call make and ill. Methyl. Okay. Call the name of the structure number 4. Together. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2. Methyl. Oh, okay. Full name. 2. Hyphen. Methyl. Hyphen. 1. Hyphen. Pentene. Very good. I think you can understand. C6H12, you tell me it has 13 isomers. I tell you already 5 isomers. So you must practice write the structure. How many? 5 here. How many? How many isomers that you must write by yourself and call the name? After 5, you tell me 13 isomer. Now 5 here. So your homework, you must write how many isomer? Understand? You tell me C6H12 has 13 isomer. Now I call you, I show you 5 isomers already. So your homework, how many isomers that you must write by yourself? 8. Okay. 8 isomers is your homework today. Practice. If you have some problem, you can telephone or ask me by use my Gmail. Do you know my Gmail? My Gmail. You know my Gmail? No. You can ask by use my Gmail. Yeah. Fonsawan.jpv54@gmail. Yeah. I start my Gmail in 2554. So I use 54. I will remember that. I change myself, use Gmail, connect my friend, another school. When I go to the meeting and I have some problem, I use my Gmail app, the patient, or wait for something. That's useful for my student here. Okay, I think you can do it. Thank you so much for your attention about how to call the name of Alkyl today. Be good student, do your homework. Okay? Okay, say thank you to me.
Thank you.
Left you.
Left you too.
I left you all the time. I think you can do your homework. If I so much. Thank you so much. Bye. Bye. ขอเสียงปรบมือหน่อย Okay. Okay. Today I will review about how to call the name of alkene. Aliphatic hydrocarbon. Understand? Aliphatic. But we call alkene unsaturated hydrocarbon. Unsaturated hydrocarbon means the hydrocarbon compound with double bond or triple bond in the structure. So we start with alkene. Alkene. When you want to call the name of alkene, the first thing you must do is you must choose the longest chain of atom and use Greek letters. Do you remember about Greek letters? If you see carbon 1, you use met. If you see carbon 2, you use
yes.
If you see carbon 3,
bro.
If you see carbon 4,
bro.
This scale, bro. Bro. Okay, beauty. If you see carbon 5,
pen.
He spell pen.
T.
T E N T. Okay. If you see carbon 6, you use
hex.
H. He spell hex.
S
E S. Okay. If you see carbon 7 atoms,
hex.
H. He spell hex.
S E
S. S-E-P-T. And if you see carbon 8,
off,
he spell off?
O-C-T.
O-C-T. If you see carbon 9 atoms,
no,
he spell no,
N-O-N.
And if you see carbon 10 atoms, D, he spell D?
D.
Yeah, very good. You can count carbon atoms and you can use the lampade. Make a cold view, then take it off the nose and the. So if the hydrocarbon is alkane, you add N at the end. But today, hydrocarbon is alkene. We will add E at the end. But the name of the alkene, the name of the alkene is different from alkane. Different because we must call the name of alkene with the position of double bond. You must tell which carbon atom starts double bond. You must tell the number 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Oh, okay. Look at the first structure. The first structure. The first structure. How many carbon atoms in the structure?
Six.
And what's the number of carbon atoms start double bond?
One.
So when you want to call the name, you put 1- and
A
C. Okay, understand? 1-
HC.
And number 2, if you want to see another structure, you want to see another structure, we call it isomer. Do you remember the meaning of isomer? Can you tell me? Who can tell me? The meaning of isomer. What is the meaning of isomer? Isomer. Same molecular formula. Different
structure.
Different structural formula. The structure number 1. C6H. How many H atoms?
12.
All of this structure. The same molecular formula. But you will see the different structural formula when you move double bond.
Technique. You must see. Move double bond. Make different structure and make different name of the compound together. Different structure and different the name of the compound.
So number two, we call.
We call
number two. What is the name of the structure number two?
Two-hexene. Why do you call two-hexene? Why do you call two-hexene? Because what?
Number five. Who's the number five? Who's number five in this loop?
Number five. Pisana.
Pisana. Okay. Pepe. Okay. Your nickname Pepe.
Why Pepe call this structure two-hyphen hexi? Why do you call two-hyphen hexi? Why? Pepe. Okay. If you cannot speak in English, you can answer me in Thai. Why? Why Pepe? Okay, Pepe, can you tell me? Why do you call two-hyphen hexi? Double bond to the man this song. Okay, grab your hand to your friend. Okay. C-H-E-N-H-E-N. English for indicated study. So if sometimes you cannot speak in English, you can tell me in Thai. Don't worry about English if you cannot tell. Speak Thai only. And after that, think in English. Okay? Think. Think in English. So in English, why do you call the number two, two hyphen hexi? Because carbon number two start double bond. Carbon number two start double bond. So we put number two before the name of the parent chain. Do you understand parent chain in Thai? So, like, parent chain in English, in Thai, not mother chain, parent chain or. So แม่หรือ so หลักเนาะอ่ะโอเค number three the structure number three we call three-hyphen hexene carbon number three start double bond okay you can move can you move double bond between carbon number four and number five can you move
no
why If you put the double bond between carbon number 4 and 5 in the structure is number 3, can you move? No. Because? Why? It will have the same name as number 2. Okay? I think you can understand. Number 4, the next. The name of the alkene. If you move double bond, move, and cut one carbon atom in the structure, then you can move double bond, cut one carbon atom, and make it bland chain. When you want to make bland chain, you must start with What number of carbon atom? You must start when you want to make bland chain. What number of carbon atom? Two. Can you make bland chain at carbon number one? Can you make bland chain at carbon number one? No. Because if you make bland chain at carbon number one, it will have L form. Or it will have U form. U and L the same as same chain. Okay. So the Subject number 4. The number 4 we call brand for the position of housekeeper. What's the number of carbon atom? 2. And how many carbon atom in brand chain?
1.
If you see carbon 1, you use?
Make.
And brand chain is housekeeper. You think about it? What the name of alkyl? You must F-Y-L in Thai. Yl. Met. F-Y-L. You call met. Met and yl. Met yl. Okay. Call the name of the structure number 4. Together. 1, 2, 3, 4.
True.
Met yl. Oh, okay. Full name, full name.
Two hyphen ten.
Very good. I think you can understand.
Yes.
C6H12. You tell me it has 13 isomers. I tell you already 5 isomers. So you must practice write the structure. How many? 5? Yeah. How many? How many isomers that you must write by yourself and call the name? After 5, you tell me 13 isomers. Now 5 here. So your homework, you must write how many isomers? Understand? You tell me. C6H12 has 13 isomer. Now I told you, I showed you 5 isomers already. You can telephone or ask me by use my Gmail. Do you know my Gmail? Do you know my Gmail?
No.
You can ask. But I use my Gmail. Yeah.
JPV54@gmail.com.
Yeah. I start my Gmail in 2554. So I use 54. I will remember that. I change myself, use Gmail, connect my friend, another school. When I go to the meeting and I have some problem, I use my Gmail as the patient or beg for something. That's useful for my student here. Okay, I think you can do it. Thank you so much for your attention about how to call the name of okay, today, be good student, do your homework. Okay? Okay, say thank you to me.
Thank you, Jesus. See you again in your goodbye.
I love you all the time. I think you can do your homework. And I so much. Thank you so much. Bye.